We are the team of E-Yantra from Maratha Vidya Prasarak Rajarshi Shahu Maharaj Polytechnic, Nasik, which is very near to you, and we are in the same campus. So we are a good friend of or good neighbor of yours. So student, we are running a technical institute after 10th, and we know that you are the student of Horizon Academy and student of ICSE board. So we came to know that you are having a syllabus of robotics in your ICSE 10th board. So today we are conducting the session on robotics, and the expert talk on the Firebird 5 robot that we are having in our laboratory of E-Yantra. So student, first of all, we are going to give an introduction of our MVP's E-Yantra team. Actually, in MVP's Rajarshi Shahu Maharaj Polytechnic, we are running total 5 branches: mechanical engineering, computer technology, electronics and telecommunication, information technology, and electrical engineering. But when you listen about robotics, so first thing come into the mind that this is an electronic-based vehicle or a machine which is based on electronics, but it is not the case actually. Robotics is a field which has the collaboration of almost all branches that we are running in our institute. Means it has base of mechanical engineering for the design and aesthetic. We are having the basics of computer and information technology regarding the programming and algorithm knowledge for running a robot, plus whatever circuitry, printed circuit board, but whatever the components are there, again the embedded programming, all these things related to the robotics are related to the electronics. And you know that automatic robot which is moving from one point to another point mostly required the batteries. So obviously there is a need of electrical engineering as well. So robotics is not related to electronics and telecommunication only. It is related to all the branches that we are running in our organization. Student, about 1.5 years ago, one proposal came to us about training on robotics from IIT Bombay, that is Indian Institute of Technology, Bombay, that is located at Powai. So I and my team took a training on it, and from there we received one robot, that is Firebird 5, which is manufactured by the company called Next Robotics, which is located in Mumbai as well. So that Firebird 5 is an educational robot on which you can perform various tasks, you can earn the knowledge of robotics. So all that things which are there on Firebird 5, that we learned a bit and then we practiced on it, and now we have developed a successful robotic lab in our institute, that is MVP's Rajarshi Shahu Maharaj Polytechnic. As per my knowledge, we are the only polytechnic in Nasik district which has a robotic lab in a polytechnic only. This lab is associated with the IIT Bombay. We run our E-Yantra robotic lab under the guidance of IIT Bombay. And for that, we have received the huge support and guidance from our principal, that is Dr. Dibu Fade sir. We are running this robotic lab. We are training our student for this robotics knowledge. So today also we are giving a short introduction, as well as we are going to show you how this robot Firebird 5 runs. Actually, when the robot concept come in front of us, we think that robot is a locomotive device which has two legs, two hands, one head, like our human being. But it is not the case. Practically, a robot can be any device which runs automatically on its own, which has its own brain, own algorithm, but that algorithm is embedded into it by a human being, that is, means us. So student, we are going to show you that robot, but first of all, I can say you a few examples of robotics, that robots. Generally, whatever ATM machine that we see daily, you go to ATM machine, you withdraw some money by inserting your ATM card, by entering your PIN, then the ATM machine withdraws you some cash. So that is a automatic money vending machine. So that is also a robot. Then your you can say your freeze is also your robot, because it automatically senses the internal temperature, the environmental temperature, and then it controls its internal humidity as well as the temperature. So it takes the decision automatically as per the program is embedded into it, and then it takes decision and it performs some action. So freeze, AC machine, washing machine, all these automatic devices, you can say they comes under the category of robot. So robot is not every time that it has two legs and two hands, one head, some eye-like shape components are fitted over there. It is not the case every time. So the robot I am going to show you today, that is an educational robot. Most of the engineering student takes this or purchases this robot, which is having cost worth rupees 39,000 plus 5,000 accessories fitted over it. So this robot, likewise, more robots are there in our robotic lab. So yes, we are training our student of first year, second year, and last year also, so that they pass out or they become undergraduates from our polytechnic with the knowledge of robotics as well. So see student, the robot which is I am showing to you, I hope it is visible clearly to you. So this robot is a robot called Firebird 5, which is manufactured by the Next Robotics, which is located in Mumbai. So as you can see from side view, it has the wheel. So on both side, it has wheels, and at the center, it has one freewheeling ball, like our three-wheeler auto rickshaw. So this robot generally has two motors. You are seeing the bottom side of this robot, which are having two DC motors, wheels, the printed circuit board, which is green in color, displays are there, output input devices are there. So this robot is an educational robot, which are seeing in this video to you. So student, we have also the videos with us. So we are going to show you that videos as well. But first of all, I'll tell you the components which are fitted over this robot. Generally, when a robot is a locomotive robot, there are different sensors and actuators fitted over it. So when this wheel also rotates by some angle, as you can see, this wheel is rotating. By how much distance or how much angle this wheel has been rotating, this also can be measured by using sensors which are located on this robot. As well as the values of sensor, means which analog sensor is giving what value, the battery status also can be seen on this display, which is shown over here. This display is a 16:2 LCD display, liquid crystal display. Again, there are indicative LEDs are there also on this robot, as you can see here. Here, the robot, the LED strip is there, where you can see the level of any sensor. You can see it over here. The batteries are there. Again, these LEDs, you can see circular, these white LEDs, you can see in circular shape for detecting the obstacle which is coming in front of this robot. So students, I am turning on this robot so that you can see the values clearly. So as you can see on this display, you can see the speed. One program is embedded in this robot. This program is rotating or movement of robot at particular speed. Means in our four-wheeler, we are having gears, correct? So at gear zero, the speed of a vehicle is zero. When we put the first gear with less speed, the vehicle is moving. We shift our gear to second, third, fourth, fifth. Likewise, we are having one boot switch over here. At this location, you can see this is a boot switch. When I press this switch, you can see this wheel is automatically rotating. Again, I am pressing the switch again. See the speed is increased. Again, I am pressing this wheel third time. As you can see on the display also, the speed has been increased. Correct? So, this is a boot switch. When we press it, see the speed will increase. See, it has become 126. Then it has become 189. And then 255 is the maximum speed. Correct? So, wheel is rotating at higher speed. Again, I will reverse the, I will shift the gears downward. See, the speed has been decreased by a single, by the values of, and at this position, the wheel is stopped and the speed of the motor is around zero. So this one particular program is embedded inside this robot. So similarly, we have done a lot of tasks over this robot and we have trained our student for this robot. As you can see at the bottom side, the white line sensors are there. The three red color sensors you can see, these are not LED. These are actually the white line sensor. Whenever you are plotting one particular path over it, suppose you have to move your robot to track particular distance, then these white line sensors are useful. Suppose if you consider one application that suppose in a COVID hospital, you have to give some medicines to the patients, correct? So one particular track will be placed from the medical pharma to the patient bed. So when you put the medicines over that robot and when you press the button, the robot will follow that white track and the robot will reach to the particular patient so that patient can pick up the medicines, and then the robot, after pressing one switch, the robot will follow the same track in backward direction and it will again go to the pharmacist. So likewise, you can deliver the medicines to the patient. When to the patient, we don't have to reach. So whenever you have to keep physical distance for that particular type of application, when you can use this white line sensors. So similarly, there are many more accessories fitted over this robot. As you can see, the different LEDs are there. When I rotate the wheel, as you can see, the LEDs are blinking. Correct? So you can see these green LEDs are there, which are blinking when I'm rotating this wheel. Correct? So it shows that your wheel is rotating by a particular angle. So the precise distance covering can be done by using that sensor also. That sensor name is positional encoder. Onto any robot, there are the different controllers are there. So these controllers actually control the robot. So here on this Firebird 5, we are having the Atmega controller, which is very fast processor. It counts the cycles, machine cycles in a micro timing. So any task can be performed within a few milliseconds only. So this much fast processing is done on this robot. So there are various accessories can be fitted over this robot also. You can fit the GPS so that you can track the location of robot. You can fit the GSM over it. So when some value is sensed by that sensors, you can text that value on your mobile phone also. Again, you can fit the camera onto this device for the surveillance purpose so that the security personnel can use this robot also. Again, various applications can be performed over this. Various sensors can be interfaced externally onto this robot so that you can perform various actions or various, you can implement various applications on this robot. So we have performed the few tasks, and this few tasks through the video, as you know that due to the COVID-19 situation, we are not in front of the crowd. So we can show you that video that we have performed in our practical laboratories so that you will get the knowledge of the robot Firebird 5. So I'm sharing the screen. Actually, due to the technical limitation, we are having the Zoom timeout. So within a 2 minute, we are going to restart our session again.